you guys and see if you've got any questions.
The most inspirational figure in video game development?
I must say it's Super Mario Brothers at this time of the talk, which inspired me the most. And I don't think it's just me. I believe that game to himself inspired many other creators in the world. I think that's probably very true indeed.
Just a quick question about the concept for Ivory Kiwi. You mentioned how Sonic the Hedgehog, the concept behind that, was come up with. I'm really interested to find out how Ivory Kiwi came about.
Well, this inspiration came from my private life, actually. I had my very first son born last year. And at that time, I became so attached to my little boy and I always wanted to care about him. And I somehow wanted to convert the feeling into the games. That's how I got inspired for this game.
Oh, that's lovely, isn't it? Gentlemen, I'd love to.
Wanted to ask you about one of the games on the Sega Saturn. I know you probably get lots of questions about Sonic and Knight. But I wanted to hear what you thought about Burning Rangers, one of my favourite Saturn games, because I know back then it wasn't too well received and was quite hampered by the Saturn hardware. Do you have any fond memories or anything you'd like to share about that particular game?
I'm not allowed to mention too much about Saturn, but the Knights for me was the very memorable game designed for Saturn. And I'm hoping that I can do something for that sort of fantastic platform once again in the future.
Other than the Sonic games, the games you were involved in were quite experimental, well, the original IP. With Probe, I noticed that the games are also very experimental, with Let's Tap and IP introducing unique gameplay. Are you tempted to build upon are you tempted to build upon an existing idea and do several sequels to expand upon an idea? Or are you mostly driven by original unique ideas?
At the project, of course, he wants to come up with new idea and establish new IP. But at the same time, I love trying out the new thing. So at the moment, I have no plan to come up with a second IP, third IP. That is the same with the Knight, which I made before. Many people ask me if I planning to make a second version or third version of it, but I decided to leave it. To move on and continue making something new.
I was wondering about a game like Ivy and what your thoughts are about core console developers moving across into mobile platform games.
I think all the new technologies, including Android and iPhone, are very fascinating as a game creator. But my probably is quite a small team and I haven't had time to think about what we can do for using those new technologies.
Actually, on that note, I mean, are you looking at PlayStation Move and Kinect? Do they excite you?
Yes, I'm very much excited about those new developments, and I do enjoy working with new hardware. So I'm hoping that I can create something exciting using those new technologies. And actually, I worked on two games, which unfortunately didn't come out, but those two games were using those two technologies you just mentioned.
Oh really? Okay. They didn't see the light of day then. Okay.
Interesting. 2D game in quite a 3D dominated era. Are there things you prefer about making 2D games to sort of 3D games? And I mean, a lot of people contribute sort of the perceived downfall of Sonic games to the fact it went 3D when the gameplay didn't really translate to 3D very well.
I still get the fun part in the benefit of the 2D games. And in a way, this idea that Kiwi was the message to those old school 2D side-scroll playing game fans. So although a 3D thing is quite fascinating for me as the game creator, I still think that the 2D has many more things to do.
How do you feel about Sonic and Mario now appearing in games together?
ソニックとマリオが臨時組で一緒にプレイしてます。実はソニックとマリオを一緒に共演させたいなと思ったのは、実は僕が
思ってですね、あの、セガの内部で。
It was actually my idea, and I was the one that approached Nintendo about it. And when I was a kid, I thought it would be fascinating to see the two heroes, you know, get together and play together or play against each other. So that was exactly what I wanted. I don't feel any funny about that at all.
What's your view on Sonic the Hedgehog 4? Are you proud to know that it's returning to its original gameplay format?
I think that Sonic 4 is a really good one. And at the recent E3 show in Los Angeles, I couldn't stop watching this little girl playing Sonic 4 because I really wanted to know if they, if the kids liked it or not. But Sonic 4 is really good as the for entire 2D games world. And I'm sure they'll
do quite well. Is that they always have a very distinctive visual style from Sonic the Hedgehog through to Let's Tap with the Tap Runners and Ivy. I was wondering, how important is a strong visual style to you as a developer?
I really appreciate the positive comment from my fans on the audio included in my previous titles. I do love music myself, but I can't do much myself, so I normally invite a team of a sound team. And I tend to use different sound team for each title, so to surprise the fans. Audio is very important for my previous title, and it will be very important for my future title as well.
Now, just before the session kicked off, Mr. Naka was busy scribbling away at the front there before you all came in. We've got to give away 5 signed, very swish, Ivy the Kiwi books here. But to give them away, quite interesting concept. Apparently this is something that happens in Japan. Mr. Naka-san would like to play rock, paper, scissors with you all. Whoever manages to make it through to the end wins the game, wins the book. So can you all stand up, please?
Here we go.
Yeah.
Game.
Yeah.
Game.
Oh.
Only
paper. Game. On. Only rocks.
Still only rocks.
Rocks.
Sorry, that's the scissors.
Your axe.
Sorry. Jam, game, boom.
He changed his.
Any scissors to them?
Jam, game, boom.
Oh.
Oh. One, two,
he's changing his.
So we're down to the final three now, I think.
Sit down.
Sandy,
if you're a rock, actually, so you're out if you're a rock. It's just the sort of paper that's left.
Yeah.